Hi everybody, this is Natalie Willis, the baby sleep trainer, and I am here to talk about toddler sleep. Everybody thinks that, dealing with infant and baby sleep is really, really tough, but I've had a lot of families share with me that while they thought infant sleep was tough, things got crazy when they got a toddler. So the first thing to do is make sure that you do not transition your toddler out of a crib too early. I have personally offered to buy my past clients new cribs for their new babies, just so that they wouldn't move their older babies out of a crib into a bed. So if your child cannot climb out of their crib and they have not gone to college yet, just kidding. If they haven't climbed out of their crib, and I would say they're 2.5 years of age or younger, please, please, please keep them inside the crib. As soon as you transition them out, I don't care who they are, it introduces the freedom to be able to come and go as they please, and then that causes all of these problems. So leave those children in their cribs as long as possible. Also, if you have a child that's in a crib and you think that they're old enough to understand the concept of a toddler clock, I have a favorite one. In fact, I have a blog post with all my favorite child products, and this one's on there. It wouldn't be a bad idea to start using a toddler clock or an okay to wake clock. There's all sorts of different kinds of products that you can get in the morning, and start to emphasize to your child, like, oh, it's time to start the day. It's time to start the day, rather. The light is green. Maybe you have a kid that's waking up really early at 5:30 and you really want them waking up at 6 o'clock. You might want to set that clock to turn on at 5:35. And even though they wake up at 5:30, wait until 5:35. And then it's 5:35, you can go in the room, start your day. Well, maybe 3, 4, 5 days later, you set that from 5:35 to 5:40. And no matter when your baby wakes up, you wait until the light turns green, just a few more minutes, and you say, oh, light's green, time to start your day. And you can really gradually get them used to waiting until a little bit later to start the day, because they're waiting for the light to turn green. And hopefully that will encourage them to at least wait quietly, or perhaps even sleep a little bit longer until you can come into the room to get them. Also, make sure that you are, if you're experiencing any type of overnight or bedtime issues with your toddler, that you're looking at their nap. So the one thing that you can always do is make sure that you're reducing their nap in order to try to alleviate nighttime sleep issues. So if you have a toddler that sleeps 3 hours a day, but they're having a really hard time falling asleep at bedtime, or they're waking up overnight, try to see if reducing that to 2.5 hours for about a week will help. And if it doesn't, try 2 hours 15. You can get all the way down to 90 minutes or even 2 hours to see if you can kind of fix some of those common bedtime issues. Or even overnight issues. Now, I have an entire toddler training method in my book that you can check out. So if you have a kid that's already out of the crib, running in and out of the room, you know, like you're having a really hard time with that, I've created a really effective, very straightforward method that you can use. You can check out my book. If you have any questions about this or anything else related to sleep for your kids, please put the question down in the comments below. Also, be sure to subscribe, and I'll see you next time.